Hello everyone, welcome to lecture 18. In this lecture, we'll talk about electromagnetic properties of soil as a mixture of water and the solid phase. So in this lecture 18, we'll mostly talk about magnetic permeability and electric conductivity. And in the next chapter, we'll talk about the next chapter, we'll deal with the complex permittivity. The most soils are paramagnetic or diamagnetic, and it can be assumed non-ferromagnetic material. So when you look at the relative magnetic permeability, and that's the magnetic permeability divided by the magnetic permeability of free space, and the real value of the relative magnetic permeability is 1 for the non-ferromagnetic material. And imaginary value will be 0. Diamagnetic material includes water, copper, and kaolinite, and the magnetic susceptibility is very small, negative number, so there should be a minus sign here. And the magnetic permeability is slightly smaller than the value of free space. And this material feels a small repulsion to magnetic dipoles. Paramagnetic material includes molybdenite, granite, aluminum, and magnesium, and the magnetic susceptibility psi is very small, positive number, like 10 to the negative 5. The relative magnetic permeability is slightly higher than 1, and these materials feel a small attraction to magnetic dipoles. And ferromagnetic material, the representative ones are iron and nickel. The atomic magnetic dipoles are closely aligned, providing a strong magnetic effect. And the susceptibility value, as you've seen before, it will be like in the order of 1,000 to like 10,000. So here, the material, it shows the some value, the range of the real magnetic permeability. And diamagnetic material, the water, in the case of water, 0.99991, and gold, 0.9999, you can see it's very close to 1. Kaolinite, it's almost 1. And paramagnetic material, slightly greater than 1. Here the greater, smaller than 1, but still you can see it's very close to 1. And if it's ferromagnetic material, then the relative permeability, the real value will be much higher than 1. And nickel is 300, and iron is 550. And it can exceed the value greater than 6,000. So then what will happen when we mix the ferromagnetic inclusion, like iron, with the kaolinite? So as the volume fraction of the iron filing increases, so it means that the 10% here is the iron in terms of the volume ratio, and 90% is kaolinite. Okay. And you can see that it starts with 1, because when the iron, there's no iron, then it will be just value 1. And it increases non-linearly with an increase in volume fraction of the ion inside. So magnetic permeability increases with increasing volume fraction of the ferromagnetic inclusion, and deviation implies that inclusions begin interacting at relatively low volume fraction. So it means that these are the theoretical estimation, assuming some geometric arrangement, and this deviation means that the iron particle or some fragments are interacting with each other, and it gives you the greater ferromagnetic properties. And here shows the effect of spatial distribution of iron. So here, this is just one big wire, like thin wire, And here the wire goes to the one end to the other end, and here it just ends at the both ends. And then still, when you see these all have the same volume fraction. Right? And to start to fragmentating the iron wires, and now at the G you have some kind of random distribution. And here the volume fraction is about 1.4%. However, the orientation and size of the inclusion varies as shown here. And what's the so at 1A there's no iron, right? And then there's no wire. And at the B gives you the biggest value. And C is next one, and D, E, where's the F? F is here, and G is slightly greater than the F. And the magnetic, imaginary magnetic permeability value, when you look at this, the imaginary value at A, almost zero, so there's no relaxation. But as the arrangement, so where is the A? A is here and B is here, right? The biggest one. The relaxation peak increases. So as the size of the inclusion increases, the magnetic permeability increases, and the relaxation frequency decreases. So kind of you can see the peak value, and peak value slightly shifts to the left side. And these are the data published in this paper. Let's talk about the conductivity, electrical conductivity. The glass 10 to the negative 12, and calcite, you can see most of the value, most of the minerals are dielectric, except here the diamond, magnetite, the positive value, right? Positive value, and seawater, right? And if it's the oil or the pure water, the electrical conductivity is very low, but seawater is very high. And the metals like aluminum, right, 10 to the 7, copper 10 to the 7, gold 10 to the 7, and iron 10 to the 7, right, 10 to the 6 and 10 to the 7. So these are all like conductive. Electrically conductive. Eh? Yep, and when you look at the electrolyte, so these are the electrical conductivity of electrolyte, and NaCl, the sodium chloride, it increases with the concentration, ionic concentration, and also sodium hydroxide or the calcium chloride, or at the low ionic concentration, the conductivity increases linearly with the concentration, like this and here. But at high ionic concentration, the mobility decreases because now the ions are too much populated, so they can collapse each other, they can hit, and causing a reduced rate of increase in conductivity of the electrolyte. So when we if you remember, recall the equation to get the electrical conductivity of the electrolyte, there was mobility times what? The balance as Z, U, and the concentration, right? So even though the concentration is increasing, the mobility decreases, so that the conductivity can decrease, or it can be like stay consistent while with the increasing in with an increasing in ionic concentration. So this table summarizes the some conditions with electrolyte and mineral and the soil water mixture. when we look at the electrolyte, as the B is the fitting parameter and C is the concentration. So with the C, increase in C or the variation in C, you can estimate the electric conductivity. And TDS is the total dissolved salt. Also, there are some equations for this. And this equation is about the effect of temperature. So as the temperature increases, then this whole value will decrease, right? So as T increases, so which means that the conductivity is a reciprocal of electrical resistivity, so it will decrease. And mineral A, B, C is the fitting parameter, and T is the temperature. So as temperature increases, the conductivity decreases. Soil water mixtures. There's no surface layer conduction. So in this case, we are not assuming like kaolinite or some clay minerals. So then Archi's law applies. So no conducting particle, and sigma W is the fluid conductivity, N is porosity, and S is the degree of saturation. And A, C, M is the fitting coefficient, and M is in the range of 1 to 2.4, and C is in the range of 4 to 5. And the second one is generalized effective medium theory. And if you know the volume fraction of each phase and electrical conductivity of each phase of the pure material, then you can estimate the sigma mix. And here, the parameter is the A. That's the kind of empirical parameter that you can use to fit the data. And I think the T is also the other one. So let's look at the electrical conductivity of soil. For dry, it's significantly lower than the conductivity of the electrolyte, the pore fluid, even at low ionic concentration. Soil and water mixture, the ionic concentration and porosity and surface conduction and percolation and anisotropy affect sigma. So first is the ionic concentration. So as the electrolyte conductivity increases, which means that the pore fluid becomes more saline, then the mixture conductivity increases. So you see the data here, it's increasing. And when you fit this data with Archi's law, then the exponent M is about 1.4. And when you just draw with the exponent of M is 1, M of 1, then when the porosity is 46%, and this is the line, and this is the line for when the porosity is 0.5. 5, so 55%. And so this is the case when you have like low specific surface particle like sand. So high specific surface particles are like clays. And when for the high specific surface particle like clays, we have driven a parallel model considering the surface conduction. So the mixture electrical conductivity is 1 minus n sigma p plus n times sigma electrolyte plus 1 minus n and the surface conduction part. So then at A portion here, when the electrical conductivity is very low, so here the EEL is very small. Here, the presence of the particle produces a mixture with a higher conductivity than the electrolyte when the conductivity of the electrolyte is very low. So this means that sigma mix is bigger than sigma EL. In this case, let me write down here. Because of this part. surface conduction part. At high electrolyte conductivity, so in this region, so sigma EL is high, the mixture conductivity decreases as the volume fraction of the fluid decreases. So as the porosity decreases, then the fluid part, the volume of that will decrease. So the volume of fluid decreases, mixture decreases. And the following figure, the plot, shows the effect of porosity. So when the here electrolyte is small and medium and high, so this is the when you look at the concentration, ion concentration here is high, small, and here is high. So as the porosity increases, you can see the mixture conductivity increases. But here, as the porosity increases, mixture conductivity kind of decreases a little bit, right? So here you can see decreases. So this means that the contribution by the electrolyte increases. So as the porosity increases, this part is decreases. So as the porosity increases, and this whole part decreases. So that's why that you have decreasing conductivity. And at the middle, it's almost like flat. But when the porosity decreases in the with the highly saline fluid, pore fluid, so then here this part will be almost zero, and as the porosity decreases, then this whole part sigma EL is constant, right? So that the sigma mixture will decrease. So then, what's the effect of water content? Effect of degree of saturation. Look at this number. It's a dramatic change. At degree of saturation is 0%, and degree of saturation is 10%. And resistivity is the reciprocal of conductivity. So then, as you dry it, the resistivity increase dramatically from almost like 10 to the 5 to 10 to the 6 and 7. So it means that almost the resistivity is infinitely high, and the soil is not anymore the conductive, electrically conductive. So for actually the dry soil is dielectric, right? So it's not electrically conductive. So when you completely dry it, then the resistivity will be really high, and the conductivity will be really small. And then when does that happen? So when you have the water phase is not continuous any longer, then the conductivity decreases dramatically. When you think about the soil like this, and here is the electrode, maybe like cathode, and this is the anode, then before the water was here, at the grain contact, right? And as you try it, the world will becomes discontinuous, like this. You get only small amount of waters. So then, now that the bridge is broken, so the ion cannot transfer or the move, deliver the electrons from one end to the other end. So the conductivity will be really low in that case, because the right now there is no path for ions to move through. So increase of resistivity beyond a certain degree of saturation and percolation saturation. So it means that the when the air volume increases too much, then the water will be discontinuous. The water phase will be discontinuous. So then the resistivity goes infinitely, very high. And formation of the continuous water phase across the length of the rock. So for example, as we like wetting the soil, then water content increases and degree of saturation increases. And then now you are building a bridge that can connect the water phase, and inside the water phase the ion can move through so that the conductivity increases. Okay, the last one is the electrical anisotropy. And electrical anisotropy shows the hydraulic anisotropy instead of the stiffness anisotropy. So if you think about like water is flowing through, and the electrolyte or the ions or electrons also flow through, because the in the soil, if typically the ion moves through the water phase, so that the electrical conductivity and hydraulic conductivity have a lot common. So caused by electroanisotropy is also caused by differences in the contribution of surface conduction and difference in the path tortuosity in each direction. So here is the result of the crushed mica flakes with sodium chloride electrolyte. And mica looks like this kind of, it looks like a sheet, very small particle like this. And it's a small particle, but it's very like plate, it's like a sheet. So then if it's aligned like this, right, and then the ion will have to move through like this, right? But that's when the current goes into in this direction. What if the current is applied in this direction? Then tortuosity will be, so the path will be shorter even though they are going the same distance. Actual path indicated by the tortuosity. So tortuosity is LA over L, and L is the specimen length, and A is actual path length. This is the LA. So if the L, for example, if you have a circular tube like this, then tortuosity, for example, like, let's use for the tortuosity, let's use like sigma, tau, and tau will be 1. Because it's just a straight line. If the pipe looks like this, right, then the tortuosity, this is the L, and this is the LA, so tortuosity will be bigger than 1. So just to give you an idea of what the tortuosity is. So then here, which one is bigger? When the ion concentration, it has the ion concentration, effective conductivity, when it's the parallel, it's bigger than when it's orthogonal. So that means again here, as I said, if the particles are aligned like this, if the current flows through in parallel with the particle arrangement, then the conductivity is higher. But when, so this is the case of in parallel, when it's orthogonal, then it will have to move and along the longer path length so that the conductivity is low. What about the ionic, the concentration is very low. So now the pore fluid is deionized water, and here still the conductivity is high when it's parallel to the particle arrangement, and conductivity is low. So the mica flakes are non-conductive inclusions that hinder electrical conduction in mixture, but at low ionic concentration, surface conduction contributes to the mixture conductivity a little bit. So this is, you can see that the ionic concentration or the electrical conductivity of the fluid or DI water is in here, and electric conductivity of the mixture is here, right? So that the bigger electrical conductivity of the mixture than the fluid means that the surface conduction played a role. These are the suggested reading, and please read through these papers, and you'll get an idea, the better insight and understanding of electrical conductivity of soil. Thank you for listening.